Today we're going to go through a sanity saving feature of iOS, which is the logging discriminator. So I was setting up a switch the other day, and what kept happening was the device wasn't in production. It uses smart licensing, and every few seconds, or maybe every minute, I was getting a logging message in my terminal that said that it couldn't reach the server, which is really irritating if you're trying to type on the screen while it's doing that. So I thought, you know what, let's configure a message discriminator and let's stop that from happening. So what we're going to do is take you through several steps. So the first step will be to show you a message and the format that takes, and then how to disable that particular message that we find on screen, the different places that the message discriminator can be active. And also we'll do a multiple parameter message discriminator because that's not as intuitive as it should be. And then finally, we'll look at some of the caveats of removing, how to remove, and some of the caveats of removing a message discriminator. So let's jump into the CLI and take a look. So I've brought up the show login command for you on the screen. And that's just to show you here that we have no active or inactive message discriminators. So we don't have anything configured at the moment. But this is the screen where you could come to view each message discriminator that you've configured and where it's applied. So let's bring up an example of a logging message. Now, the easiest way to do that is to just go into configuration mode and then come back out again with Control-Z. And you'll get a message there to say that someone has tried to make a configuration change, and it'll say where it is that they've done that. So if we look at this one here, it says that we've tried to configure from the console, and it shows several separate sections at the start of that message. So we have first of all the facility, which is sys, and then the next digit is the severity, and then the piece after the dash there is the mnemonic. And then we have the message body after the colon. And we can filter on all those different pieces using with a logging discriminator. Just give us a bit more flexibility of what it is that we're trying to block. And now we've seen a real life logging message, what we're going to do now is suppress that message using logging discriminators. In the scheme of things, this particular logging message isn't particularly chatty, so you're probably not going to need to suppress it. But as an example, it works perfectly fine, and it's easy to replicate in a home lab. So we enter configuration mode, and we enter the command logging discriminator, and then we give it a name. In this case, we're just going to call it drop-me, and this name has to be 8 characters or under. And then we enter the part of the message that we want to filter on. In this case, it's the message body. And then we enter the keyword drops, and that's because we want to drop these. We don't want to see these messages. So we enter the keyword drops and then just copy and paste the actual message body, which is the configured by console, from console by console. This should be entered without quotes. We've created a filter, but we still need to apply it for it to take effect. There are several locations that you can apply it to. For this particular demonstration, I'm just going to apply it to the console and to the monitor, but you could also apply it to a remote syslog server or to the buffer log, which is local to the device. The syntax to achieve this is logging console discriminator and the name of our discriminator. And the same goes for the monitor. We just replace the word console for monitor. So next, let's verify that the configuration has been applied under the show login command. And we can do that by looking under the active discriminators section. We can see there that there's an overview of the configuration that we've entered. And then if we look a little bit further down the screen, we can see the areas that particular discriminator has been applied to. So we can see drop me has been added to the console and also the monitor, but we deliberately haven't applied the buffer to the discriminator to the buffer, so that we can demonstrate next that the log messages still appear there even though we have suppressed them in the console. Before we do that though, let's clear out the buffer just to make it a little bit easier to read. And then we can do our old trick again of entering the configuration mode and exiting back out to generate the logging message. As expected, we can see that the message has been suppressed from our view, but it is still recorded in the logging buffer. If we didn't want the message to be recorded in the buffer, we can just simply add our discriminator to the buffer as well with the logging buffer discriminator and then the drop me name that we have there. I'll empty the buffer again. We'll go in and out of configuration mode, and we can see that if we take a look back at the buffer, we'll see no trace of the message. Cool, eh? To make it a little bit easier, what I've done with the multiple parameter login discriminators is I've already set that up, and I've basically done that with BGP. So I've deliberately misconfigured BGP so that it throws out many error messages. And if I look at the show run at the moment, so I can show you that login discriminator, we can see that it's called drop BGP. It's dealing with the mnemonic and it's dropping the notification or the adjacency change mnemonics. So if we just use the pipe symbol on your keyboard, that will give you a logical OR, which means if in your error messages you see it sees the word notification in the mnemonic or adjacency change, then what it will do is it will drop it. What I've done is to apply those to the console and to the monitor. So let's just turn on BGP and we'll see that the notification and adjacency change messages only go into the buffer and they don't get presented to the screen. We will see some other BGP messages that pop up to say that there's an issue, but they won't have the words notification and adjacency change in the mnemonic section of the log. Let's do it. Configuration mode, and then I'm under router BGP 1, and then we'll do no neighbor 10.0.0.2 shutdown, and we can see straight away we've got differing messages in there. We've got a neighbor reset message just here, we got a message dump log that's come through, but we aren't seeing any of the adjacency change or the notification messages printed to screen. If I turn this off for the moment, because it's just going to get annoying. So I've shut that neighbor back down again. And if I go to the log, we can see that all of the messages are in there. So the notification messages are in there, the adjacency change messages are in there, plus the ones that we could see on screen as well, neighbor reset and the message dump ones. A little bit too far. While we're in here, we can also see that it shows that the login discriminator is active that we've configured. And it also shows us where it is active as well, so on the console and on the monitor. There is another way to configure multi-parameter login discriminators, and that is to use multiple different sections of the message to filter on. So in this login discriminator called Drop2 that I've created, we have a facility and we have a mnemonic in the same configuration command. So it works a little bit like an ACL, where it will actually just hit the first thing that it sees, and if it matches, then it will drop it out. So unfortunately, if you were to look at a logging message from BGP, for example, that we had in our previous demonstration, and we were filtering on the facility of BGP, it wouldn't be an and, it wouldn't say BGP and a notification, then drop. It would be, if it sees BGP, it will drop the message, full stop. So essentially, all of your BGP messages will disappear with the command that we've entered called drop2, which is probably not what you want. That's just something to look out for. It is a nice way to be able to have multiple things in one configuration command, but you've just got to be aware that whichever it hits first will, it will exit out at that point and it will drop that message. So just be careful of that. There are a couple of different ways to remove your login discriminators if you finish with them, neither of which are perfect, but I'll show you both. So on our screen here, we've got the currently configured login discriminators. And what we're going to do is just show you how to remove this login discriminator here. So you'll find that you can't just go into configuration mode, use the no version of the top command there, and hit enter, because it won't let you remove it until you've removed it from the individual places here. So we'll take the login monitor first, and we'll just use the no version of that. Okay, so it's taken off of the monitor now, but you may notice that if you do show run including logging again, I might have to do the do version of that. You'll see now that it's actually set it to no logging monitor, which is not exactly what you wanted, because that has just turned off all logging altogether by using the no version. So another way that you could do it, if we take the console version of that command, so logging console discriminator, we could just, instead of doing the no version, we just do logging console, and that is another way to remove it instead. That will actually just remove the configuration that we applied before. So let's arrow up a couple of times. And you can see that the login discriminator could now be removed with the no version. But we still want to turn on our login monitor again, which is simple as just typing login monitor. Cool. So if we look back in show log, we can see there are no discriminators active or inactive, and there's nothing applied to any of our different locations on there, which is what we wanted. So that concludes this video. I hope you found that useful. If you've got any questions, please ask them in the comments below. You can find the full article on this. There's a few extra pieces that you may need to know or want to know if you go in more in depth into this. So you can find that at my blog, which is www.writemem.co.uk. I'll put that in a link in the description for that as well.